Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today I'm going to fix out a weird error. There are four zeros, 000023. It asks you to contact support. Don't do that. They will tell you get a new printer. Instead, grab a $100 bill and bring your printer to Greensboro, North Carolina, or watch this video.
Hey guys, it's Abby here. So we have a 000023 error. And in this one, the print headlock is stuck in the upright position. So I'm turning these gears here on the far left side, and you'll see that the rod above my hand is turning, but it's not moving the print headlock to unlock it. So I'm going to go ahead and take off my scanner. There's three FFC cables attached to the scanner to the main board. Go ahead and take those off. And then I just have a ground wire that is connecting my scanner to the main board. It's not to the main board, I'm sorry, but it is still to the printer. So we need to go ahead and unscrew that ground wire. Now I can just pop off my scanner. So I'm going to show again here. This is where the print headlock is locked, and I'm going to have to push it down manually so I can move the carriage over. Once I pull it over, there's no paper in there that I see. And I'm trying to figure out why I can still move the gears on the far side, but why that wasn't moving the print headlock at the same time. So I can move that, and we see that it is moving now, but if you have better eyes than I did at this point, you'll see what the error here was or what was causing this. So here's this print headlock, and as I move it, you'll see that it does move a little bit, but it isn't moving the way it should be. So if you look behind where the waste tank is, you'll see that there's a bigger gear here, and there's a piece of styrofoam stuck back there, which is what's making the gears turn a little bit sideways or get stuck. And so I think this is about where I found it. Here is where I just noticed it. So once I pulled that out, and there was also another smaller little piece of styrofoam stuck in between these gears here. So once I pulled that out, then I was able to push my carriage all the way back over, and my print head lock was working correctly now. I gave it a few spins with the gear and put it into the lock position and the unlock position. And you can also see in the back where the paper feed, where you feed the paper through, those gears spin. And so now I just need to take off this side cover so I can put my scanner back on, and then we'll test just to make sure that the carriage can move back and forth and that the print headlock goes into the unlock position. So take that side piece off, and this allows us to reach to the main board. So here we need to put the scanner back onto the hinges. For me, with this model, it's always a little bit tricky trying to line it up, so I have to get eye level with it and just make sure that it's usually that right side that I need to make sure that I have the hinge just fitting in correctly with the scanner. But once I get that, I can put my three FFC cables in there. There's one on top of the main board and then two on the back. The smaller FFC cable goes on the inner side of the main board, and the larger FFC cable goes on the outer side of the main board there. Screw in my ground wire, and then that's when I can put my side cover back on. It's pretty easy. Just lift up the scanner a little bit, and then you can fit those tabs back into the bottom. All right, so then we'll power back on my printer and we'll give it a test, and it does move past where the print head locks, so it unlocks and it moves past. This time I just got a scanner error, which I didn't get last time. Then I got the paper jam, which was the print head lock. So we fixed that, and I'll just go back and look at my cables. So happy printing, everyone. We fixed it.
Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Your subscription and like is what keep us going. Please visit us at www.bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.